Hello everyone, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying refrigeration and air conditioning. In the last video, we have seen about the term of refrigeration and refrigeration capacity, then power input. Okay, in this video, we will see about the difference between COP and EER. What is EER? COP and EER. EER is an energy efficiency ratio. Okay, then we will study about BEE star rating, Bureau of Energy Efficiency star rating. These two topics we will study in this video. Let's start the topic. Here EER, then COP. EER is the energy efficiency ratio, which is widely used in USA. Okay, then COP. COP is the equivalent measure in SI unit and widely used in UK. Now, second difference. EER measures the cooling performance of air conditioning. This is the most important difference. This is the most important difference between EER and COP. EER measures the cooling performance of air conditioning, remember, okay, and COP measures the heating performance of air conditioner. Now, I think you got confused because of these two. I'll explain, then we'll go deep into this video, okay. But here, you just remember that EER measures the cooling performance of air conditioner and COP measures the heating performance of air conditioner. Actually, in the previous videos, I have told so many times that COP of refrigerator and COP of heat pump. Actually, that thing was told because so that you can remember easily. Now, there is some difference because commercially, when we will purchase an AC which has both system, heating system and cooling system in market, the AC has both the systems, like inverter AC has both the system, cooling system and heating system. If we calculate the performance of that AC for cooling, that is EER. If we calculate the performance of the same AC for heating system, that heating performance or heating system, then it is called COP. Understood? I'll explain when we go deep into this video. Okay. Now, in simple term, EER is the amount of heat removed by air conditioner per hour. Remember this word, conditioner, by the air conditioner per hour. Per hour you have to remember. Okay. Is divided by the power consumed by heat. So, from this definition, we can write EER is equal to amount of heat removed, means BTU per hour. Amount of removed from a storage space per hour, okay, and divided by electrical energy input, that is W. Okay, this both these quantities, if I have ratio, then it is called EER. Understood? Now, if we talk about COP, if COP is the ratio of heat output of heat pump to its electrical energy input. That means for heating system or heat pump, I have already told that refrigeration effect is QH, that means QW, it is in kilowatt, and divided by electrical energy input, whatever energy we are giving to the system or we are giving to the heat pump, that is in kilowatt. Okay, this is the difference between the definition of EER and COP. Now, AC with higher EER is better. It is already shown here. EER is inversely proportional with the electrical energy input. Now, if EER is better, then electrical energy input is lower. It means saving is more. Understood? So, AC with higher EER is better. Now, heat pump with higher COP is better. I've already told this thing. If in the same way you can consider here, COP is inversely proportional to the electrical energy input. If COP is more, then electrical energy input is less. Somewhat there is a similarity between these two, ER and COP. But just difference is that ER is for cooling performance, COP is for heating performance. You have to remember this. Now, EER has unit BTU per hour divided by watt. This is the unit of EER. EER is not unitless. Understood? Okay. Now, COP. COP has no unit. From here, this kilowatt and this kilowatt will cancel. Now, COP has no unit. COP is unitless. Okay.
तो चलिए देखते हैं ER एंड COP के बीच में डिफरेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन एग्जांपल. नाउ फॉर ER, इफ एन एयर कंडीशनर जनरेट्स 13,648 BTU पर आवर ऑफ कूलिंग फ्रॉम 1000 वॉट इलेक्ट्रिकल इनपुट, देन व्हाट शैल बी द ER? आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन द फॉर्मूला फॉर ER इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड. ER इज इक्वल टू the heat absorbed by the air conditioner in BTU per hour divided by the electrical energy input. Okay, we will put that values here, 13648 divided by 1000. Now, we can write here like this, 13.648, or after rounding off, I can write 13.65 BTU per hour per watt. This is the ER for air conditioner if it is using for cooling. Cooling performance के लिए, if we are using EER, then this is 13.65 BTU per hour per watt. Okay. Now, for COP, if an air conditioner generates 5 kilowatt of heat from 1 kilowatt electrical input, then COP, what shall be the COP? Remember here two terms, an air conditioner and air conditioner. In ER, an air conditioner generates this much of cooling. Remember this thing. An air conditioner generates this much of cooling for ER. And for COP, if an air conditioner generates 5 kilowatt heat, that means here an air conditioner is generating 5 kilowatt of heat. That means it is a heat pump. Okay. For COP, now COP for heat pump shall be the ratio of heat generated from the heat pump divided by the electrical energy input. Now, from that definition, we can write COP is equal to 5 kilowatt divided by 1 kilowatt. Now, COP we can write is 5. Here, there is no unit. I have already explained that COP has no unit, but EER has unit. So, I have written BTU per hour per watt. Okay, friends. Now, remember here, there is a two important thing for ER and COP. What are these two things? Both the words are equally important for selection of hot and cold inverter AC. Remember this thing. If you go to the market to buy the air conditioner and you are selecting an AC which has both the facilities, heating and cooling. And heating and cooling, that is the inverter based technology. If you go to buy that AC has ER and COP, both the term on the technical specification of that AC, both the term will have COP and EER. In the next slide, I'll show some technical specification of one company. Okay, you have to remember this thing. Second, the relationship between the COP and EER is equal to, EER is equal to 3.412 times of COP. Okay, you have to remember this relation. There is no derivation in your course. Here you have to remember just the relationship between EER and COP. Okay, friends, now let's see an example. When you go to the market to buy an air conditioner, on that AC, if you buy an AC which has both the facilities, heating system and cooling system, in that case the COP and EER are also there on the technical sheet of that AC. I am giving here one example of Mitsubishi company. In this example, you can see there are so many models. I'll take just one model, and I highlighted one. I'll explain. Okay. Now, in that case, you can see that for cooling, some word is written S-E-E-R. For cooling, S-E-E-R is written. And for cooling, what is the S-E-E-R? 5.6. What is S-E-E-R? 5.6. Remember here, what is S? And E-E-R, you know, energy efficiency ratio. What is S? S is a seasonal energy efficiency ratio. If this AC is using for, is why this S-E-E-R? You have to think about that. Because this AC, if you are using in summer seasons, then it is using for one season only. So S-E-E-R is for one season only. If you remember the definition of EER, what was the definition of EER? EER was the definition for amount of heat removed from a storing space per hour. Per hour, whatever amount of heat is removed, that is EER. That means for a shorter period, for a shorter duration, 1 hour, 2 hour, 24 hour, that is shorter duration, we consider EER. And SEER consider for season, for a longer duration, like completely summer season. Okay, that is the difference. And further, you can see heating or warmer season. For heating, there is a SCOP, scope. That means seasonal coefficient performance. It has the same meaning. If the same AC is using for heating, then SCOP for that AC shall be 4.9. Shall be 4.9. You can easily see from the highlighted models. Okay. And SCOP is also for complete season, and the COP for shorter duration. You have to think and you have to remember these things only. Okay, friends, this is the technical sheet. You can easily watch all the data, whatever written on this. This is only just for your knowledge. So, friends, if you learn from the book, that is SCER and SCOP, you will got confused. I am giving here the technical specification of Mitsubishi because so that you can easily understand, you can easily grasp the concept. What is SCER and what is SCOP? Okay, friends. Now, let's move further. We will study here Bureau of Energy Efficiency Star Rating. Okay. Bureau of Energy Efficiency Star Rating. What is that? The star rating is a measure of energy efficiency of an appliances. It's a 5-point scale. You can easily see in the diagram that there is a 5-point star. The appliances which has more star, that is more energy efficient. The appliances which has 3 star, that is 3-star AC. Suppose if you have AC and on that AC there are only 3 star, then that is a 3-star AC. If there is a 4-star, that is 4-star AC. That means more the star, more is the performance of an appliances. Okay, friends. And more the star, more the efficiency of the appliances, more the performance of the appliances, means consumption of power is very less. Means saving is more. Understood? So now you can understand that how the star rating is very important. Why this star rating is given? Friends, have you thought that why this is this star rating is given? It is because a common person who is buying an appliances or air conditioner, if you say the COP of that AC is 5.2 and he doesn't know about the COP, and if you say the EER of that AC is 4, and you don't know about the energy efficiency ratio, In that case, that star rating helps. The person who doesn't have the knowledge of COP or EER, he can easily tell that this appliances has 5-star or 4-star. If it is 5-star, it means energy saving are more. If it is 4-star, it has energy saving less than 5-star. Understood? Because of this reason, star labeling is done on the appliances. Okay. There are so many appliances on that star rating is done, like air conditioner, refrigerator, washing machine, etc. Understood? BEE is an organization, Bureau of Energy Efficiency. There is an organization, government organization, which do all these labeling on their equipments. Okay, friends. And why we are doing this labeling? Because so that we can protect our environment from global warming. This is linked with the global warming, and this is linked with the natural resources which we have in our country. Because of that reasons, we are doing the analysis on these equipments so that we can improve the performance of all these appliances. Okay, friends, now you can easily see the BEE label in the video. In BEE label, there is a 5-star, you can easily see. Then there is an energy efficiency ratio values there. Then BEE rating period, that means latest one is better, and it is older one, it is not better. This label is showing the complete picture so that you can easily find out that this machine is better for my home. Okay, so friends, in this video we have seen about the difference between EER and COP. Then we have seen BEE star rating. Okay, now in the next video we will see that Carnot refrigerator and Carnot heat pump, because the maximum efficiency of a refrigerator or any heat pump, that is the Carnot refrigerator or Carnot heat pump. That refrigerator and heat pump is based on the principle of reverse Carnot cycle. So reverse Carnot cycle, Carnot refrigerator and Carnot heat pump, we will see in the next video. And for this video, thanks for watching and have a good day. Thank you.